Today we're going to build the KiwiCo Labs disc launcher and target for practice. Hope you guys are ready to take aim and get building. All right, let's build this launcher. Take the handle and place it into the main disc platform, like so. Then take this screw and tighten it all the way down with your Allen wrench. Tighten it down all the way until it doesn't wiggle. Next, grab this piece and make sure that this bolt is sticking upwards. Next, grab a bolt from the toolbox and assemble it into the handle. You're going to want to make sure that this is tightened all the way down and is super snug. There shouldn't be any room to wiggle and no gaps. Next, grab the piece with the spring and set it onto your big platform. Set in the slot so it can slide back and forth. Make sure to slide it all the way back so we're ready for the next step. Then flip it over. You can take the piece with the little bolt sticking up and set it into this groove. Yay! This will also slide back and forth. Also make sure that it's lined up all the way to the back. Next, grab two light bolts and screw them in. These bolts will go through all three layers, so make sure you're screwing into the spring piece underneath it. To make sure that they're screwed down all the way, you can grab another piece of wood and use that to tighten it. Here's a fun fact. The groove on the top of all of our plastic bolts is 3 millimeters wide, so you can use any piece of wood that you have in your crate, or you can use a coin or any other household object that fits. It's really important that there's no wiggle and no gap. All right, so now that everything's nice and snug and assembled, you can check out our safety feature that we've added. If you pull it all the way back and try to push it forward, it shouldn't fire. This safety feature makes sure that it doesn't fire without a disc in it. So if you flip it over, you can see this little red arm prevents it from sliding forward when there's nothing pressing it down. Ta-da! Safety first. Next, we're gonna grab the clear plastic cover. This helps the disc shoot straight every time and make sure your fingers don't get in the way. All right, it should fit in just like that with the logo sticking out on that side. Next, grab the big clear tube and set it right on top. Make sure that the opening is facing the handle. Then get two really long screws and secure it all together. Get two nuts and screw it down really tight. Just like everything else on this build, make sure it's really snug. There's a ton of forces going into this disc launcher, so you want to make sure that everything's nice and secure. All right, time for some discs. This yellow piece right here is really cool. It takes one disc from the hopper and then loads it up to get ready to fire. When you're firing the first disc though, you want to load it underneath the hopper. So just like this, you want to push it all the way under so that it's kind of lined up with that tube. Then you're ready to fire. If you pull the handle all the way back and you're not able to push it forward, it's working correctly. What's happening is the disc is either not loaded or not loaded correctly. You're gonna wanna make sure that there's a disc loaded under the yellow part and centered under the tube. Remember that red lever we pointed out earlier? The safety switch? When the disc is loaded properly like this, it'll release the safety switch and you'll be able to push it all the way forward and launch that disc. If you've loaded up a disc and it's still not moving forward, make sure to center it under the clear tube. See that little red safety lever? The disc will need to press down the edge of that safety lever in order for you to slide forward. If your disc gets stuck for whatever reason or jammed, it happens. Use a little pencil to squish it out. If you're playing with it and you're noticing that the disc launcher is jamming a lot, try not to shake it around so much and hold it level. This machine uses gravity in order to feed the next disc properly and to release the safety lever. So it's really important that you hold it level. So it works best when you hold it straight. Also double check that this screw is not in front of the yellow piece. So if you look from the side and you see a big gap like this, that's no good. But all of that needs to be squished together and flat. You see on the right side, everything is sitting nice and flush and stuck together really well. That's exactly how you want it to look. You should see the screw sit in here like this. And the other side looks like this. So go through and make sure that your blue screws and your green screws are super tight. To make sure they're screwed down all the way, you can use any piece of 3 millimeter wood or coin from home. Awesome, let's see what this thing can really do. Remember to load your first disc in from the side and then load up all the other ones on top in the hopper. Every single disc launch, it'll automatically load the next one. Choo, choo, whoa. All right, next, let's build some really cool targets. All right, first, grab this little orange piece that looks like the letter H. Notice that there's a short side and a long side and little prongs that stick up. Next, grab the piece of wood with the letter A on it. Slide your orange piece short side in first, squish it all the way up into that groove so the prongs are pointing up. It should look just like this. Then repeat these steps for the wood that says B and the wood that says C. Make sure to double check that everything's in the correct orientation. It should sit nice and flush. Next, grab this long wooden bar. Slide in the wood with the letter A on it at the very end. It might be a tight fit, but make sure you push in all the way. Then slide the wood with the letter B on it into the middle. Next, slide on dowels into the correct hole. Then we're gonna make a little gear sandwich. Make sure the gear teeth are pointing to the left and down, just like this. Next, you're gonna wanna sandwich on the two blue rings. Because this target needs to spin easily, it doesn't need to be squeezed really tight. All right, now grab the wood with the letter C on it, and we'll put that in the last slot on the wood bar. All right, now we're gonna put on the other dowel. The order here is really important, so watch closely. First, we're gonna put on a blue ring, then put on another yellow gear. Make sure that the gear on this dowel are pointing to the right and down. Then you're gonna slide the rest of the dowel into the hole and make sure that those gear teeth mesh. They should turn just like this. All right, now that those gears are meshing, we can secure it in place with two more blue rings. Double check that your gears are matching up just like this. When you spin one dowel, it should be able to spin the other one. Okay, next we're gonna get these little blue clips. Notice that one side of the clip is a little bigger and has these teeth. Push the bigger end of the clip onto the middle of one of the wood dowels. Then push one of the cardboard targets into the other end of the clip. And make sure to push down the red target for the next step. Then repeat for the other side and then slide on your second target. All right, so one target should be sticking up and the other one should be facing down. When you hit one target, the other one should pop up. All right, repeat part B to build your second target. Okay, so here's some troubleshooting tips. So if your targets aren't flipping really easily, like they don't want to turn, they feel kind of stuck, just go ahead and loosen those blue circles. So they can rotate freely. Awesome. You're noticing that one target flips and then the other one doesn't do anything at all? Then go ahead and check your gear teeth. In order for one target to activate the other, those gear teeth have to be meshed. Yeah, there we go. That's some meshing action. All right, so I just finished building and now I get to play. So one of my favorite ways to play and the one we had the most fun doing in the office was actually our sharpshooter test. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a full load of 10 discs. And I'm gonna start with my flippy targets up close, and I'm gonna take a step back each time I can get one to see if I can get all the way to 10 steps. All right, so I'm gonna start at 4 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes! 1. 1. Yes! 1 back. I've got 5 discs left. Let's see if I can get to 10 steps. Yes! New record! So there's actually like so many cool games you can play, especially because this disc launcher will shoot the discs straight and accurate again and again. And a lot of that has to do with the physics of how it's built and how the discs are being spun. There's kind of two things that are helping this disc fly really, really smooth and really, really straight. One of those things is its spin, and the other thing is its shape. So for the spin, if you've ever tried to throw a frisbee just like that, it's not gonna go anywhere, right? If this were a real frisbee, I'd hold it on the end and I'd throw it like this to move it in a big circle motion and get it to spin. And that once you start spinning it in this direction, it doesn't wanna go this direction or that direction or any other tumbling direction. It just wants to keep spinning in the same way it is. So that helps it make sure that it's flying really straight and really flat. The second effect that makes it a really, really predictable and really cool flight path
is something called the Kiwanda effect, or lift. It's very complicated physics and aerodynamics that basically means as it's moving through the air, as the air goes over the top, there's this nice little curve. So it says, all right, I'll just go past, no problem. But on the bottom, there's this big lip. So as the air needs to get out of the way, it pushes around and then doesn't know where to go. So it turns the corner and goes back up. And that pushes on the bottom of the disc and creates lift. It's the same way that airplanes fly, actually. So if you look at the shape of airplane wings from the side and lots of other stuff that flies, it has this kind of shape to it. So those two things together, the spin, which makes it really stable as it flies, and then the lift, which helps it float instead of just falling like a brick, are the two things that help this disc launch straight and accurate every single time. So you've probably seen lots of frisbee launchers and disc launchers on YouTube, and there's a lot of really cool ones out there. But I really like this one that we made here for KiwiCo Labs because it's actually all mechanical powered. There's no motors and there's no wires and no batteries required. It's all about transfer of energy. So as you push it forward, it charges up this big metal spring that you can see here. Boing! Just like pulling back a rubber band to stretch it. And then as it pushes all the way past, it transfers all that potential energy into kinetic energy and launches that disc right out the end. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys learned something and had an awesome time. If you want to see more content like this, make sure to subscribe to our channel. Thanks.